Winter is finally over here in the UP, which means bears are just waking up from an unseasonably long slumber. Although exciting, taking a hike to an actual bear den can be a bit scary.
I've been outdoors all my life, and the opportunity to see a bear den was very attractive to me. Whether there's a bear there or not isn't really the point, but it'll give me an idea of what bears do all winter and how they survive without eating anything for such a long period of time.
But before heading into the beast's intimate lair, we got a few tips which also required using our imaginations.
Do you think it's going to be in a cave-like area or in the ground or in a tree? So that gives people a good idea of what they might expect a bear den to look like. And then I usually wait until someone in the group sees it before I point it out. It's not quite what you might expect.
And surprisingly, we didn't have to hike far before someone spotted it.
Oh, we're here already.
Now, we weren't on a designated trail per se, just a footpath off South Boundary Road. But soon enough, there she was. Not quite what I was expecting. Definitely a lot smaller than the huge cave I had envisioned.
This is a birch tree. We'll often do this. When they germinate, they'll germinate out of old stumps sometimes. And then when the tree starts growing, the old stump will rot away. And that's how you see that exposed root system like that, which is just perfect for a bear to excavate its den.
You can typically tell if it's a male or a female bear den simply because male bears don't care about what their den looks like. But female bears, on the other hand, would typically decorate with some leaves or moss.
And they can actually smell a crumb that is microscopic to our eyes. So they can smell something even if we can't see it. So it's best if you even keep your toothpaste, your chapstick, anything out of your tent at night.
So when hiking in bear country, you might want to avoid carrying any food or any type of scented products. While lying inside the den, it appeared to be about 6 to 7 feet deep, and from my estimation, no more than 2 feet tall and 3 feet wide. Close quarters for such a colossal creature. Although we didn't spot any bears on the hike, our tour guide did bring along some props to help illustrate some of the finer points, like how thick a bear's winter coat feels, a careful inspection that left most hikers fascinated.
And these teeth are very sharp, which does indicate that this animal does eat meat. However, if you look on the inside, you'll notice that the back teeth are flat. So just like our teeth, if you run your tongue along your back teeth, you'll feel that they're fairly flat. And that means that this animal also eats plant material.
75% of a black bear's diet actually consists of plant material. The rest is made up of berries, fish, and fawn in the springtime. But each chomp is important for researchers. The teeth marks can tell a bear's age, sex, and even the number of cubs they've given birth to. Although there were none on hand to grin and bear it, we were able to see how our hands matched up to their front paws. According to the guide, bears are actually afraid of us.
It sounds really silly, but if you talk in a calm voice, and then eventually back away slowly. So a bear will pretty much mostly feel like they need to be aggressive only if they're being cornered or if it's a female bear with cubs. But typically the female bear with cubs will push her cubs up a tree or away from the area and then let you get away if you are backing away slowly.
But you definitely don't want to run, because unless you can reach speeds of up to 35 miles an hour, the grizzly will be bearing down on you in no time. Despite the risk of having an encounter with one of the den dwellers, some say they'd be more than willing to bear it again, hoping next time to spot a black bear up close.
Bears are really amazing creatures. Really, any animal in this park is pretty amazing.
I think it was pretty cool, the bear den. I mean, it's pretty dark in there, but I could still see it wasn't that dark.
Bears venture out as far as 100 miles for food. Some even travel 40 miles just for an acorn. But for them, it's worth it. Storing up food for the winter is, after all, their number one goal, as they burn 3,000 to 4,000 calories a day during hibernation. For ABC 10 and CW5 News Now, I'm Danielle Davis.